Hey, yo, just want to let you know the first iteration of the official Sickos merch is up on runitbackphillyshop.com. I designed this logo myself. I'm very proud of it, and I'm giving you 20% off. All right, the promo code is Sickos20. Go to runitbackphillyshop.com. It's on t-shirts, hoodies, beanies. Use the promo code Sickos20 for 20% off. No, this lady does not come with your order. I'm sorry. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, we got some news. We got some news that might give us some hope, or we're just really 76ers sickos and we're lying to ourselves again. But we have something important that we need to talk about. Before we talk about that, I want to let you know I am on Bleacher Report app today at 1 p.m. Eastern time under the 76ers tab. Click the link in its description and you can watch the Bleacher Report show on the Bleacher Report app. Me and what we're talking about on that show is how the 76ers can survive the rest of the season, everything that needs to happen. We're going to do a little bit of Kyle Lowry talk and Buddy Hield and if Embiid's coming back and things like that. But I would love for you to join me on Bleacher Report at 1 o'clock Eastern today. Link is in the description, okay? Now let's get into this video and what we're talking about. And we're going to talk about this a little bit more on the Bleacher Report show too. But this is just my initial reaction, and you know I got to give it to you Sixers sickos before I give it to damn Bleacher Report or anybody else, all right? So let's talk about what just popped up and why I'm getting excited. All right, first things first, shout out Sixers Galaxy, the best page on Twitter. If you're not following, what are you really doing with your life? Joel Embiid attended the team practice yesterday as the organization remains optimistic about his return before the playoffs. Our favorite lunch lady, Ramona Shelbourne, said on NBA Today. Here's what she said. And again, I don't know why Ramona Shelbourne is the lady that these teams relay information to. I don't know how she got to where she's at, but shout out to her for getting there. The Sixers don't want to put any time frame on it until he starts ramping up, but I'm told he went to practice yesterday. He got there early to see how everything was in the morning. His enthusiasm is there. So this is news because I said the Sixers are going to sell you hope. I said the Sixers aren't going to tell us what's going on with Joel Embiid. They're not going to tell us if he's coming back or not. They're going to sell you hope the rest of the season. Now we're getting clear reports that they really are optimistic that Joel Embiid could return at the end of the regular season and be with the Sixers in the playoffs. And we're getting clear reports that Joel Embiid is also optimistic about returning. And he was at practice yesterday. I think that is news, you know, because a lot of people were saying he's going to get shut down for the season. They're lying to us. They're selling you hope. They're going to come out eventually and say he's done for the season. That's what I was saying. Now we're seeing that I don't think that's going to happen. I think there is a chance that he comes back and they're showing optimism and Embiid is showing optimism. Let's look at the other tweet from Sixers Galaxy. There is optimism in Philadelphia that Joel Embiid can return at some point during the regular season. We were saying if he does come back, it might be halfway through the second round. The Sixers would already be cooked. There's optimism that he could return at some point during the regular season, at least close enough to the playoffs to get his rhythm heading into the playoffs. But the Sixers don't want to put any time frame on it until he starts ramping up. But I'm told he went to practice yesterday. He got there early to see how everything was in the morning. His enthusiasm is there. This is huge news, and this is a huge step for Joel Embiid if he is going to come back. Best case scenario, obviously, is him getting back before the playoffs start with some time to get his conditioning and everything back and see how the knee feels and everything heading into the playoffs. Now, when Joel Embiid had the surgery, you heard all the doctors we were talking about. We were reading reports from that this meniscus surgery, you know, if they did just remove a damaged portion of the meniscus, it could be as early as an 8-week return. We were not optimistic about that. But Sixers Galaxy reminds you that this was posted on February 6th. Some dates to keep in mind with Joel Embiid's expected recovery timeline. Sixers All-Star break, February 15th, 21st. We got through that. 4 weeks from today, which is 4 weeks from when Joel Embiid had the surgery, is March 6th. 6 weeks from Joel Embiid having the surgery, March 19th. 8 weeks from Joel Embiid having the surgery, April 2nd. Playoffs start April 20th. They said once he had the surgery, it was reported from Woj that he will be reevaluated in approximately 4 weeks. That would be on March 6th. So sometime around March 6th, we'll probably start to hear if Joel Embiid is going to start to practice and start to ramp things up. We'll hear that around March 6th, you know. I think best case scenario still, if the 4 to 8 week thing is true, I think best case scenario would be 4 weeks, but I think that's a little bit unrealistic for him to start practicing on March 6th. If that happens, I'll be absolutely blown away. I think best case scenario, if this is all true, is Joel Embiid could start practicing on April 2nd and the playoffs start April 20th. All right, man, we are over on the Sixers regular season schedule. We're going to find out. Here's the month of March. March 6th, they play the Memphis Grizzlies on ESPN. So I think best case scenario, you know, that the March 6th is 4 weeks. What did we say was 8 weeks? What did we say was 8 weeks? Let me go back to the tweet. What did we say was 8 weeks? 8 weeks is April 2nd. Let's check it out. April 2nd. April 2nd. If Joel Embiid, best case scenario, comes back April 2nd and starts ramping up, maybe a minutes restriction, something like that, we would have OKC, Miami, Memphis, San Antonio, Detroit, Orlando, and Brooklyn. The last game of the season would be the 14th, and then you would have 6 more days until the playoffs start, and that is the play-in tournament starts April 20th. So that's what it would look like if, best case scenario, Joel Embiid comes back and starts ramping up in 8 weeks. Okay, let's look at the standings. Roster depth, more transactions, tickets. Where the hell's the standings at, bro? NBA standings. Here we go. So we'll look at where the Sixers are sitting at right now. They're sitting in the 5th seed. Indiana is right there at, what, two and a half games behind? I think 2.5 games behind. Where's the games behind at? Where's the games behind at, bro? Anyway, Indiana's right there at 31-25. Miami's right there at 30-25. Orlando's right there at 30-25. The Sixers could fall to the... I think it's realistic, really, to not, if you're not getting Joel Embiid back, if you do get him back in April, that's great. They have a lot of tough games coming up, man. Three against the Knicks, I think. Two against the Bucks. Not that the Bucks are great, but still, the Sixers without Embiid struggle to beat a lot of teams in the NBA. They got Cleveland a couple times. They got Boston again. They got a tough schedule coming up. I think they could end up as the 8th seed. If they end up as the 8th seed, here's the scenario. Here is what's going to happen. Listen to me, and listen to me closely. Look at me. I'm the captain now. Here's what's going to happen. The Sixers are going to fall to the 8th seed. They are going to play the play-in tournament without Joel Embiid. They're going to lose a game. They're going to win a game. They're going to come out of the play-in tournament as the 8th seed. Joel Embiid will have been ramping up that whole time. And the Philadelphia 76ers will knock out the Boston Celtics in the first round of the playoffs. You heard it here first. Save the damn video. I don't care what you do. That's what's happening. Manifest it! Speak it into existence. That's all I got, man. I just wanted to sell you guys some hope. All right. Don't forget, tune in to Bleacher Report with me at 1 p.m. today. Bleacher Report app. Link is in the description. I'll see you there. Peace.